Bernie Sanders comes out on top as the Democratic frontrunner with Pete Buttigieg on his tail. But will the establishment snatch the nomination from Bernie's hands yet again? The real question is, why does the Democratic establishment hate Bernie so much but love Pete? If they try to rig the primary again, President Trump could easily win 4 more years. Welcome to another episode of Pod and Country. I'm your host, Lisa Smiley. Before I forget, let me remind you to subscribe to the Daily Cooler channel on YouTube and hit the bell to get notified of any new content. And join millions of Americans who have liked and followed us on Facebook. So, the Democratic establishment must be in panic mode right now. Impeachment has failed, Trump's been acquitted, and then President Trump gave a fantastic State of the Union address last week, honoring Americans and laying out all his wins, and Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats just looked like sore losers. And impeachment doesn't seem to have hurt Trump one bit. In fact, Trump's approval rating is at its highest at 49%, according to the latest Gallup poll. Thanks, Nancy. Couldn't have done it without you. And then we also had the Iowa debacle, which made the Democrats look completely incompetent when they couldn't even count the votes. And now the DNC's nightmare has come true. It looks like Bernie Sanders is the frontrunner for the nomination. He basically tied for first place in Iowa and won New Hampshire. And now he's gaining momentum in the other states since then. Close in second at this point is, surprise, Pete Buttigieg. Really, that is quite the surprise. Now, unfortunately for the establishment, Joe Biden is tanking big time after coming in fourth in Iowa and fifth in New Hampshire. So at this point, he really doesn't have a chance. All the media coverage, his experience, and the fact that he was Obama's VP for 8 years didn't translate into a successful campaign, and Joe Biden just doesn't have it. Now, Elizabeth Warren, I think her best days are behind her. And Amy Klobuchar seems to have taken some of Elizabeth Warren's thunder. She's done surprisingly well, coming in fifth in Iowa and third in New Hampshire. And Michael Bloomberg, well, he seems to be trying to buy his way in with his billions of dollars. I think he has some kind of savior complex. He thinks he'll be like the Democrats' version of Donald Trump. Billionaire comes in at the last minute to save the day. But honestly, he's a little late in the game. By this time in 2016, Trump had a serious movement going with huge support from the grassroots. And Bloomberg has none of that. He is gaining in the polls though, so we'll see what he'll do. So the reality is Bernie Sanders, a socialist, is the front runner of the Democratic Party. Can't say we didn't see this coming, but that should be scary to all patriotic Americans. Bernie is an avowed socialist. He's never met a communist he didn't like. He honeymooned in the Soviet Union. He's praised communist murderous dictators like Fidel Castro, and he's praised bread lines of all things. And he's been this way all his career, but America is now so far gone that he actually has a chance. Now, it's hard to wrap my head around just how far our society has devolved to get us to this point. But that is the reality of the situation. But to be honest, all the Democratic candidates are pretty crazy leftists this election cycle. Bernie's just more open about it. So what is the Democratic establishment going to do about Bernie this time around? They already rigged the election last time, snatching the nomination from Bernie and handing it to Hillary. Are they going to do that again? Defy the will of the people? Because unfortunately, its leftist base wants Bernie. But Bernie is the establishment's worst nightmare. The establishment doesn't want to give the nomination to Bernie. To me, he's an existential threat to America. But to the establishment, he's an existential threat to them. They're used to having control. They can't control Bernie, though. He's crazy to me and to them. Bernie is genuinely anti-establishment. He calls out the elites, he calls out Wall Street, he calls out the politicians. I mean, he doesn't care. He's a revolutionary. He literally wants to tear down the system, including the Democratic Party. So at this point, they're holding on for dear life. Because if Bernie gets the nomination, the powers that be won't be in power anymore. And it's crazy to think that they might actually prefer to let Donald Trump get four more years instead of letting Bernie destroy the party from within. Well, their disdain for him is on full display. Hillary Clinton has some harsh words for Bernie, saying, "Nobody likes him. Nobody wants to work with him. He got nothing done. He was a career politician. It's all just baloney, and I feel so bad that people got sucked into it." And the media was eager to highlight her words, despite the fact that Bernie campaigned on her behalf last election cycle. MSNBC's Chuck Todd just compared Bernie supporters to Nazi brown shirts. And a couple of weeks ago, CNN joined forces with Elizabeth Warren to attack Bernie, accusing him of sexism by claiming that they had a conversation in which he said a woman can't be elected president or something to that effect. And CNN was quick to come to her defense. And it seems some Democrats don't actually want socialism to take over the Democratic Party. Chris Matthews seemed very concerned about the socialist direction of the Democratic Party.
I have my own views of the word socialist, and I'll be glad to tell them, share them with you in private. And they go back to the early 1950s. I have an attitude about them. I remember the Cold War. I have an attitude towards Castro. I believe if Castro and the Reds had won the Cold War, there would have been executions in Central Park, and I might have been one of the ones getting executed.
My generation, the millennials, unfortunately can't remember the Cold War. They didn't go through the Red Scare, and most of them don't even know that communism has been tried and failed over and over again. And Democrats like Chris Matthews may be outnumbered because Gallup just released a poll. More than 75% of Democrats would support a socialist for president. Old school Democratic strategist James Carville also had some harsh words for Bernie.
They're not interested in socialism and the revolution and all that foolishness you hear. I'm not about a revolution. I'm not an ideologue. There's a certain part of the Democratic Party that wants us to be a cult. I'm not interested in being in a cult.
Well, he's not wrong. Bernie literally wants to start a socialist revolution, which is so ironic because at the beginning of the race, all the candidates were fighting to see who was the most leftist of them all, who was the wokest, who will give Americans the most free stuff. Well, the answer is Bernie. And unfortunately, the energy and the passion is on the leftist socialist side of the Democratic Party. And Bernie is more popular now than even 4 years ago. And he has a huge movement of hardcore devoted followers in his camp. So, who will the DNC try to back instead to try to stop Bernie's momentum? Well, it looks like it could be Pete Buttigieg, who is in second place at this point and gaining ground. So, there's an interesting dichotomy between Bernie and Pete. Bernie Sanders is 78 years old, and he's been in politics for decades. Like I said, he's always been openly socialist. Politically, I think he has a lot of baggage. I mean, you can find footage of him praising communists. If the Democratic Party is trying to win over moderates, Bernie isn't going to do that. So I get that he's a liability. And Republicans could really use that against him. I mean, just think of the ads. If you don't want a socialist for president, vote for Trump. Yes, please, I'll do that. So let's look at what Bernie plans on implementing if he becomes president. The Green New Deal, which would ban affordable energy, nuclear energy, cars and planes, and cows, with a price tag of $93 trillion. Also, Medicare for all. In other words, government takeover of the whole healthcare industry. It would eliminate all private insurance, and it would require $34 trillion in new federal spending over the first decade. All I hear is everyone's taxes are gonna go through the roof. He's also for abortion through all 9 months. He says that abortion is a constitutional right, And under his Medicare for All plan, he would repeal the Hyde Amendment and force taxpayers to pay for it. And on the Second Amendment, he wants to ban the sale and distribution of assault weapons and prohibit high-capacity ammunition magazines. So say goodbye to your right to bear arms. He's also pro-open borders. He wants to decriminalize illegal border crossings and give health care to illegal immigrants. But not too long ago, he was actually against those things, calling open borders a Koch brothers proposal. But it looks like he's caught up with the most radical open borders advocates of his party. And on taxes, he says he'll make corporations like Amazon pay their fair share of taxes. Bernie, who is a millionaire and owns multiple homes, seems to really despise billionaires. Well, that's no surprise, considering socialism promotes envy and covetousness masked as compassion. It's okay to hate rich people, guys. It makes you compassionate. So it's no wonder the elites don't want Bernie to win the Democratic nomination, because he'll tax the heck out of them. Voting for Bernie is basically voting for everyone's taxes to go up, not just the elites, so that the government can hire millions more bureaucrats to run our lives at gunpoint. That's socialism. Anyway, Pete Buttigieg, on the other hand, is more palatable to the establishment. He's just 38 years old, so that's a 40-year difference. That's like almost two generations younger than Bernie. He's the mayor of South Bend, Indiana, so he doesn't have a lot of experience, and he was a virtual unknown before announcing his presidential run. He's also a veteran who served 6 months in Afghanistan, but a lot of Americans are questioning what exactly did he do in the military. But he's a media darling who's gotten lots of positive media coverage. I mean, just Google Pete Buttigieg and you'll find pages of glowing profiles and stories by the mainstream media about him. And he's so hip, he's even gay, married to a man. And he says he's a Christian and Episcopalian and uses his version of Christianity to further the leftist agenda. And he's young and malleable, so in some ways, he is like Obama before he ran for president. So you can see why the establishment loves him. He's the cool, hip, up-and-coming Democrat. And did I mention he's gay? The media wants to remind you just how woke he is. And unlike Bernie, he does play the political game. He's the candidate of the elites and the billionaires. According to Forbes, Pete Buttigieg has most exclusive billionaire donors of any Democrat. And that's something Bernie has been quick to point out recently, as Pete has surged in the polls. But now that he's going up against Bernie, Pete is now painting himself as a moderate, as the alternative to Bernie, but he isn't. He once praised Bernie's socialism, and just last year, he was standing up for socialism in the Democratic Party. So he's kind of like Obama, leftist on the inside, but tries to hide it with a lot of BS. And in terms of policy, he is like Bernie, but understands that America isn't quite ready to embrace all-out socialism just yet, but he is no moderate. For example, he supports the Green New Deal. He wants amnesty for illegal immigrants. He would offer Medicare for all, but also keep private health care. He wants to expand gun control. And he's also pro-abortion through all 9 months and would force the taxpayer to pay for it. So all typical leftist positions. But there are also major problems with his candidacy. Funnily, some on the left don't think that he is woke enough. Is Pete Buttigieg gay enough, they ask. Which just proves you can't ever be woke enough for leftists. And he hardly has any support amongst minorities. He's not as well known as the other candidates like Joe Biden. And the fact that he is openly gay will be a huge obstacle in winning over religious Americans like Catholics, evangelicals, Mormons, and Muslims. Minorities also tend to be more socially conservative. But can you imagine Pete Buttigieg going up against Donald Trump? I mean, Trump would crush him. Nonetheless, the establishment may prop him up just to try to beat Bernie, or maybe it'll be Michael Bloomberg or Amy Klobuchar. But Joe Biden and Elizabeth Warren seem to be on their way out. What's funny is that the Democrats have united against Trump for so long, and now that impeachment is over, all eyes are on them. Nothing to distract us from the infighting, and it doesn't make them look good. At this point, I don't see how the Democrats could rig the primary against Bernie again without there being a huge backlash from his supporters come November. So here's the Democrats' dilemma. Do they let socialist Bernie win the nomination like its leftist base wants and potentially alienate moderates? Or do they try to rig the primary and run a moderate like Pete and potentially alienate its leftist base? To be honest, Bernie is the only Democratic candidate with a serious movement behind him. So in some ways, he's like Trump. And they're addressing some of the same problems that average Americans are concerned about, and that's what's made them hugely successful. Their solutions, however, are obviously the complete opposite. But can you imagine if it does end up being Bernie versus Trump in the general election? I mean, it would be quite a showdown. Well, at least the two choices would be abundantly clear. Does America want socialism or freedom? Because those are the two choices before America in 2020. Okay, that's all for today. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to follow The Daily Caller on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. You can find me on my public Facebook page at Lisa Smiley Page. You can also follow me on Twitter at Lisa S. Smiley. Feel free to write to me your thoughts on the election at lisa@dailycaller.com. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.